Markets first, they are seeing a mixed picture as investors assess data from Spain, which showed inflation rose for a second straight month in July, while Germany reported a 13.2% drop in imports. That's the sharpest decline in over three decades. As for Wall Street, futures are flat after a three-day winning streak for the major U.S. indices. Investors are keeping an eye on more jobs data, as well as GDP and home sales numbers due out this Wednesday.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Citigroup, which has been accused by the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission of underreporting its expenses related to its underwriting business. Citigroup is trading higher before the bell as it has agreed to pay a $2.9 million penalty. Also in focus, shares of HP after its fiscal third quarter revenue report fell short of Wall Street estimates on weaker demand for computers. Shares of HP are down 8% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on Ørsted shares, which took a plunge after the renewable energy company warned of impairments worth $2.3 billion in its U.S. portfolio. Shares of Ørsted are down over 22%.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mostly higher on positive consumer confidence and job openings data from the U.S. overnight. Japan's Nikkei 225 posted its third straight day of gains. Australia's ASX 200 jumped more than 1% after the country's inflation print eased more than expected in July to 4.9%. China shares lagged as the stimulus cheer runs out and property jitters bloomed again. That's after Country Garden Holdings said it will issue some $34 million in new shares to repay its debt. China's largest property developer also set to report a $7 billion loss in the first half. Other notable stocks in the region, shares of Toyota climbed more than 1% after it resumed operations at all of its plants in the country. That move comes a day after a system malfunction brought production to a standstill. Also in Japan, shares of 7-Eleven operators 7&I slipped 0.7% on reports it will sell its department store unit, triggering a plan for a rare workers' strike. Here at home, Philippine shares rose for a second day with some analysts pointing to bargain hunting.
We don't expect any dramatic movements. I mean, most of the foreigners have left. Volume is very thin. So there's little impetus to think we can go down significantly more. But at the same time, there's not much suggesting we can go much higher. Longer term, our fundamentals are still there. So yeah, the Philippine consumer, we have a lot going for us, you know, young population and whatnot. So if you're much longer horizon, then you know I would take this opportunity to buy consumer companies on weakness.
The Asia-Pacific economy is slowing down under the weight of weak global trade and the uncertainty of China's economic recovery. That's according to the latest report from Moody's Analytics. The financial services firm says while the region will avoid a recession, a new period of robust growth won't likely happen until mid-2024. It sees India and Vietnam leading the growth this year, but at a slower pace than 2022. China is expected to just meet policymakers' goal of about 5% expansion this year, as high debt and lack of demand within the property development industry holds its economy back. As for the Philippines, Moody's already lowered its growth outlook for the country following weak second quarter GDP numbers. It says growth will likely remain below target unless fiscal policy or export trade provide an extra boost. At least one analyst also says the government really needs to catch up on spending.
We are less sensitive to China weakness than our neighbors as our GDP relies more on domestic consumption for growth. Unlike Vietnam, for example, that is more China-centric from supply chain for exports. That said, we are there is some dependency there, particularly maybe on the semiconductor export side. So that will have an effect. But we do think we have downgraded our earnings expectations for the Philippines as well, more due to government spending not being there. Less on the export side, while it is a concern, the main driver for our downgrade of earnings growth expectations for the year is really due to the inability of the government to spend. The national government really needs to get reacquainted to spending coming from the 3 years of pandemic lockdowns.